Hi friends, for our online resources visit the link in the description. Today's reaction I'm going to discuss is a Grignard reaction, which is a famous reaction named after a Nobel laureate, Victor Grignard. And what happens in this reaction is RMGX, aryl or alkyl magnesium halide, attacks the positive or say partially positive carbonyl carbon to give alcohol. When in this particular example where I have selected ketone as a representative example, you end up getting a tertiary alcohol. Now I'll tell you how this Grignard reagent is formed. Now this Grignard reagent is formed when an alkyl halide, say that can be a methyl bromide or say anything, ethyl bromide or ethyl chloride or ethyl iodide, when it is treated with magnesium in presence of anhydrous THF or say ether, like etherical solvents. The etherical solvents are required to stabilize the complex formed by the Grignard reagent. And here what happens is the magnesium adds in between the alkyl and alkyl halide bond, that is RX bond, and it gives the Grignard reagent. Now you will have this mechanism, like what is the mechanism, is it a difficult thing for one to remember? It is a simple thing. Like when you see and take any alkyl halide, here halide being an halogen atom, being an electronegative, comparatively more electronegative than the alkyl group. So here the alkyl carbon will carry partial positive charge, whereas the halide will carry a partial negative charge. Now what happens when you have a Grignard reagent, magnesium insert between these atoms, and it actually creates the negative charge on the R group, and whereas the charge on the halide will more or less will be a negative. But the R group charge here, if you carefully see, it is a negative than the what it was in the alkyl halide. Here magnesium bears the positive charge. So what you should remember that here the R group is electron rich group. Now it will be able to attack other groups. I hope you have understood this whole thing over here. Now moving on to the mechanism of the Grignard reaction. So what happens when you have Grignard RMGX and ketone, say as I have taken acetone in this example, as I have told you earlier that R group has a negative charge. Now it will attack the partially positive carbonyl carbon, and the electron density will move on the oxygen as shown here. Like now the counter ion are magnesium and this magnesium plus is the counter ion here. When you work it up means work up is the procedure when you quench any reaction, say by water or by any other reagent. So in this case generally people will use the acidic workup. Acidic means acid will be added to the water, and then that solution will be added to the Grignard reagent. Now when what will happen, the counter ion will be Mg plus will be replaced by the hydrogen, and you will have the XMgOH and the tertiary alcohol as a product. I hope you have understood this mechanism. Mechanism is pretty simple. If there is any doubt, you can post it in the comment section. Now moving on to the ketone, as we have already seen, the ketones give tertiary alcohol. Now you see the aldehydes. So aldehydes gives, when they attack this Grignard region, when attacks on aldehyde, ultimately you will end up in getting secondary alcohol, right? I hope there is no doubt with this example. Now you got tertiary alcohol, now you have secondary alcohol. Now what if I have to make a primary alcohol? For one to make primary alcohol out of Grignard reagent, I should replace the aldehyde. I should use the aldehyde where both the atom attached to the carbonyl carbon should be hydrogen. So for that the only one example, that is formaldehyde, is the best choice here. And when Grignard reagent with its negative charge when attacks on the formaldehyde this carbonyl carbon, you'll and followed by the acidic workup, you'll end up in getting primary alcohol. Now we have seen we can prepare primary alcohol, secondary alcohol and tertiary alcohol out of Grignard reagent. Now moving on to the some other application. The other application is, what will happen if the ester is reacted or treated with the Grignard reagent. So here what happens when you use two or more equivalent of Grignard reagent, what happens first, in first step the ketone forms, but it is not isolable. The ketone form, the second equivalent of Grignard reagent will add to the ketone form to give tertiary alcohol. Now say for we take one example, one equivalent of RMGX. What do we say? What will be the product? Will we get the ketone? No, that's not the happening. That's not what happens. Actually, what we get here is a tertiary alcohol again. Then you'll and how is that possible? Like here we get the half, and tertiary alcohol, with that we get the ester back. Means whatever the ketone formed, it will react with the remaining Grignard reagent and you will get the tertiary alcohol. So why this happens here? The reactivity of ketone is much higher than the ester towards the Grignard reagent. So whenever some Grignard whenever any Grignard reagent adds to the ester, it forms ketone, and the ketone immediately reacts with the remaining Grignard reagent to give the tertiary alcohol. You will never be able to isolate ketone from the Grignard reagent. You got it? Never able to isolate the ketone from the Grignard reaction of the ester. So what is the way? How can we prepare the ester ketone from the Grignard reagent? So the simple thing is, when we treat acid chloride with Grignard reagent, here you get ketone, as simple as that. So what happens here? Here the reactivity of Grignard reagent towards acid chloride is much higher. So here you, if you use only one equivalent, you will be able to isolate the ketone. I hope you have understood this lecture. If there is any doubt you want me to clarify, you can ask in comment section. Friends, if you have liked it, please share and subscribe to our channel, Global Online University. Thank you.